हेलो, टुडे वी आर स्टार्टिंग आवर न्यू चैप्टर, द सेकंड चैप्टर, एंड दिस चैप्टर इज ऑन द ड्यूटीज ऑफ कस्टम्स. यू मे कॉल इट टाइप ऑफ ड्यूटीज, काइंड ऑफ ड्यूटीज और क्लासिफिकेशन ऑफ कस्टम ड्यूटीज. ओके, द ड्यूटीज विच we impose under customs primarily serve two purposes. The first purpose is the very obvious purpose. It is, yes, earning revenue for the government. And the second purpose is imposing custom duties, certain kind of custom duties on certain goods. It really protects us from dumping. It really protect our local industry from the outside threats. Okay. Now let me tell you what kind of duties basically we impose under customs. The first duty is the basic customs duty. Please note that basic custom duty we impose through Customs Act. This is section 12 of the Customs Act, basic customs duty. Okay. Now, barring this custom duty, all other duties we impose through Customs Tariff Act. Okay. It is only the basic custom duty which is being imposed through Customs Act. Otherwise, all other duties of customs, they are through the Customs Tariff Act. Okay. So first, let us study about basic customs duty. The name suggests, you know, everything here. This is the basic duty of customs. So that means if you import certain goods and the goods are dutiable goods, you would have to pay a BCD. Okay. There are various rates of BCD on various kind of goods. On a certain article, BCD rate may be 10%. On some other article, the rate may be 15%. Okay. So as such, there is no general rate for BCD. It depends on what kind of commodity you have imported. Okay. So what are the various points you need to remember with respect to BCD? Yes, there is one very important point here. The rates under BCD are classified into two categories: standard rate and the preferential rate. Standard rates and the preferential rate. Standard rate means the rates which are given for basic custom duty for various commodities. But what really is a preferential rate? Okay, that we need to understand. The preferential rate of basic customs duty, what it is. Please note that we have got, we here means India, we have got a list of preferential area. This means there are certain areas which we prefer. We really want to, you know, do our international trade preferably with those areas, with those countries. Okay. We do have a preferential area list, and the countries which are appearing in our preferential area list, it simply means that yes, we give preference of international trade with those countries which are there, which are listed in our preferential area list. Okay. Now, if an importer, he imported those goods which have been manufactured in a preferred country. Now, you know what is the meaning of a preferred country? Preferred country means a country which is listed in our preferential area list. So, if an importer, he has imported goods from a preferential country, the goods are manufactured in that preferential country, and the importer claims, makes a specific claim that since he is importing these goods from a preferential country, kindly give me the preferential rate of basic customs duty. Okay. So if these conditions satisfies, then yes, custom department, custom authorities, they would provide him the preferential rate of basic customs duty. Now, with this discussion, I think this will be clear to you that the preferential rate of BCD is a rate which is slightly lesser than the standard rate of BCD. That is why they are, you know, they wish to claim the preferential rate. Okay. Now, in case on certain articles, let us suppose the BCD rate is 10%. The preferential rate for the same, on the same article would be less than 10%. It may be 9%, it may be 8.5, it may be 8%. But it would be less than the standard rate of basic customs duty. Okay. So, why a lesser rate is given? Why a preferential rate is given? Because India wishes that our international trade must grow with these preferred countries. Okay, that is why we are giving a comparatively lower rate of duty when you import goods from those countries. Okay, now let me tell this in other words. To get preferential rate, the importer would have to fulfill two conditions. First condition is that the goods must have been imported from a country which is a preferential country for India. The goods, those goods must have been manufactured there in the preferential country. Okay. And second, very, very important, the importer would have to make a specific claim for preferential rate of BCD. In a case where the importer imported goods from a preferential country, but he has not made a specific claim that he need to avail the preferential rate of duty. He claims for the preferential rate of duty. If he hasn't made that claim, custom department, those people, they don't have any responsibility on them. That they would give you the preferential rate. If you want a preferential rate for your imports, okay, you need to claim that. Okay, the condition number one is that your import must be of those goods which are manufactured in a preferential country and you are importing them from the preferential country. And the second is that you must make a specific claim claiming the preferential rate of duty on your imports. Okay, only when you satisfy these two things, then preferential rate of duty, which is slightly lesser rate of basic custom duties in comparison to the standard rate of BCD, you can avail that rate. Okay, now please see on the board, the first duty is basic customs duty. Okay, and under basic customs duty, there is a classification given. First one is standard rate. That means the basic custom duty can be applied on standard rate or it could be applied at the preferential rate also. Preferential rate, there are two conditions you need to satisfy, then only you would get this preferential rate. Number one, goods imported from a country listed in our preferential country list and goods must be manufactured in that preferential country. Preferential area country. Number two condition, importer should claim the preferential rate. So if you are not claiming, even though you are importing goods from the preferential country, you would not get the preferential rate. Okay. Now, the second duty is basically a surcharge by the name of social welfare surcharge. Okay. Social welfare surcharge, the rate is given for it and the rate is 10%. Social welfare surcharge, we would call it SWS. The rate for SWS is given. It is 10%. Okay. And for gold and silver, the SWS rate is 3%. So you must remember this. Okay. BCD rate would always be given to you in your questions. Always. But SWS rate may not be given to you. So if it is not given, you must remember it that the rate for SWS, it is 10%. And in case of gold and silver, it is 3%. Okay. Now, the duty at number 3 is IGST. Duty at number 3 is IGST. Yes, you remember it. This is IGST, Integrated Goods and Service Tax, right? Let me give you, you know, a background of this IGST duty first. This would give you some clarity about how this IGST is appearing here in customs. Please see, before the implementation of GST in India, we used to have, you know, specific indirect tax acts like central excise, like service tax, like VAT. Okay. Now, at that point of time, we used to have two custom duties, one under section 3.1 and the other one under section 3.5. First was the additional duty. The other name for the additional duty that time was CVD. Okay. And the second duty was special additional duty or SCVD. The additional duty, it was based on the central excise duty, and the special additional duty, it was based on VAT that time. Now, you know, with the implementation of GST, all other indirect taxes, they have been subsumed in GST. So that means now no central excise, mostly it is not there. Yes, some very small, you know, sphere is left for excise. VAT, completely it is off now, right? So the duties which were based on central excise and VAT, obviously with the implementation of GST, those custom duties by the name of additional duty and special additional duty, they also went off. They also, was serving no other purpose then. Because when central excise and VAT subsumed in GST, and since the additional duty and special additional duty was based on central excise and VAT, when there is no excise, no VAT, how can there be any additional duty or the special additional duty? So obviously, with the elimination of excise and VAT, obviously the additional duty and the special additional duty of customs, they also got eliminated. They also got completely off from the act, right? Now, in place of those two duties, we now have this duty by the name of IGST. And now I think you can guess that yes, this IGST, it is based on the GST, right? Because earlier additional duty was based on central excise, SAD was based on VAT, they have now been gone, and now in place of them, it is IGST. And IGST, because the other ones gone because of the GST, and because of GST, we have now this IGST. The IGST of customs would be based on GST. Okay. Now, if you remember this, that the rate of IGST, it would be the rate of GST applicable on those kind of goods. For example, you are importing, say, commodity X, and on commodity X, when it is supplied here in India, the GST rate is, say, 12%. Okay. So when you are importing such kind of article which attracts a 12% GST rate in India, the IGST rate for customs, it would be the same 12% rate. Okay. So IGST is based on GST. The rate, the GST rate on a particular commodity, if you are importing the same or similar kind of commodity, the IGST of customs rate would be the same. The rate which is the GST rate on such goods when they are being supplied here in India. Got it? No problem here. For example, let us suppose that I imported this pen, and this pen, when supplied in India, when anybody makes a supply of this pen in India, the GST rate on this pen is, say, 12%. So when I am importing these pens, the IGST rate of customs would be the same rate, 12%. Okay, got it? So this is IGST. it is being imposed under section 37 of the Customs Tariff Act. This is section 12 of Customs Act. This is section 37 of the Customs Tariff Act. Okay. So far we studied three duties. Number one, basic custom duty. The important thing there to remember is the standard rate and the preferential rate. The second was SWS, 10% and 3% rate. Third is IGST. The rate would be as applicable on such goods while they are being supplied here in India. The GST rate, the same rate would be for the IGST of customs. But for your convenience, let me tell you that the practical questions would always give you the IGST rate there. So you don't have to remember the GST rates on various commodities. That would be given to you in your question. Okay. So let us understand these three duties by way of an illustration. Let us try to see how these duties are actually computed. Okay, the computation, because you would get, you know, numerous questions, practical questions on these things. Okay, so let us now try to understand how to compute these duties. So an illustration is given here. Please see, EX means example of computation of duty, how to compute these duties, right? Now let us suppose that the value of goods you imported is rupees 100. So value of goods is 100. Okay. First you need to apply the basic customs duty. The rate would be given in your question. Let us suppose the rate of BCD is 10%. So BCD at 10%. The question here is 10% is the rate, but what is the value? On which value you need to apply this 10% rate? So please remember, I have given number 1 to this value. You are going to apply the 10% rate on number 1. That means on the value of goods, you need to apply the basic custom duty rate. If the rate is 10% and the value of goods is 100, so 10% on 100, the BCD, amount of BCD comes to 10 rupees. Got it? So computing BCD is very simple. Just you need to have your value of imported goods, apply the BCD rate, and you would get the amount of BCD. Got it? Now coming to SWS. In case of SWS, you need to remember the rates, 10%, and in case of gold silver, it is 3%. So now apply SWS here. SWS at 10%. Now on what value you need to apply the 10%? Please note, 10% on point number 2. That means whatever BCD amount you have computed, on that amount you need to apply the 10% rate of SWS. So here the amount of SWS would be 10% on 10, that means rupees 1. Okay, now make a total of all these. Value of goods plus basic plus SWS. This comes to 111 rupees. Okay, no problem here. Now come to the computation of IGST. How much of IGST would be there? Third duty, IGST. Now apply IGST. You need to know that the rate of IGST, which would be given to you in the question, okay, but on what amount, on which amount or value you need to apply that rate of IGST. Please see, very important here. IGST at the rate of 10%, this 10% would be given to you in the question. IGST at 10% on number 4. What is number 4? Number 4 is the total of value of goods plus BCD plus SWS. It means that IGST is to be computed on the overall value, which includes value of goods, the basic custom duty, and the amount of SWS. Okay, just make an addition of all these amounts. Whatever the amount that would be, apply the IGST rate on that amount. That would be your IGST duty amount. So when you apply 10% on 111, this comes to 11.1. That means now the total value of your imported goods, including the duties, would be 122.1. Simple. See, this is very important, because in almost all the questions related to the computation of duty, or even related to the computation of assessable value and then duty, you need to apply this. Okay. Now, up till here, we have discussed, and I hope everything is clear. Now, coming to the next duty, it is the GST compensation cess. Please note that on the basis of GST or with respect to GST, there is IGST also and there is GST compensation cess also. What is GST compensation cess? Now, compensation cess, okay? This cess, it is applied only on two types of commodities. Only on two type of, not just two goods, two type of commodities, two type of goods. What are these types? Number one, luxury goods. So if you are importing luxury goods, okay, you would have to pay the GST compensation cess also on import of luxury goods. What is the meaning for luxury goods? I can give an example. The luxury cars, high-end cars, luxury motorcycles, okay, and there could be numerous other luxury products, okay. Just to understand, I gave you the example of car because, you know, car itself comes into, if it is a good model, it comes into, you know, luxuries. Not the day-to-day car I am talking about. And yes, not the day-to-day motorcycle I am talking about here, but there are certain motorcycles which are nothing but luxury products. Okay, they are so costly, right? And all of you, you know better than me about motorcycles and cars. So, these are luxury products. On luxury products, on luxury goods, you need to pay the GST compensation cess. Okay. Now, the second type of goods, they are called demerit goods. Okay. Very important. Please understand the meaning of demerit goods. Merit means something good, virtuous. Demerit means something bad. Demerit goods. We include those kind of goods here in demerit goods, the goods which have, you know, some kind of a negative impact either on the society or on a particular person or onto the environment, overall environment. Okay. Such kind of goods, they are called demerit goods. The examples, the first example would be, say, pan masala or tobacco. Everybody knows about it. Pan masala, chewing pan masala, it would be very injurious to health. Right, so it is one of the demerit product. Then motor vehicles. Why motor vehicles? I agree that motor vehicles, they facilitate, you know, in various ways to us, but still they are considered harmful. Why? Because, you know, they are one of the major contributors of pollution, right? There are immense adverse impact on our environment because of the motor vehicles, right? Pollution, okay? So, yes, they are also considered as demerit goods. There are number of other demerit goods also, like even coal is considered as, you know, demerit goods. Coal, again, because when you burn coal, it pollutes the air. Okay, so because of that, again, it, you know, it is taken as a demerit. Your carbonated drinks, they are also demerit goods. Okay, so GST compensation says it is applicable only on two type of goods. Number one, luxury goods. Number two, the goods which we call the demerit goods. Got it? Now, the important thing. When you need to work out the GST compensation cess also, the amount of GST compensation cess, how to compute that? Okay, I would tell you that. But before that, I want to make two points. These are very, very important points. Point number one, please see that in relation to GST, under customs, we have two different duties. Number one is IGST, number two is GST compensation cess. Okay. Under GST, there is a very important concept of ITC, Input Tax Credit. You all know about it. ITC, Input Tax Credit, you all know it. Okay. Now, please note, and this is very, very important. If we are making certain imports, and on our imports, we are paying certain duties, right? Whether any ITC would be available to us on the duties which we paid at the time of import of goods. So the question here is that whether any ITC is available on custom duties or not. Okay, so very important question. The answer to this is this. ITC is available, but it is available only and only against IGST and against GST compensation cess. So if you are paying certain custom duties, okay, there could be 4 or 5 kind of duties involved. Out of all such duties, you can claim ITC only and only for the IGST you paid and for the GST compensation cess you paid. For all others, there would not be any ITC. If you want to claim ITC against the basic custom duty you paid, no, you would not get it. There is no ITC against basic custom duty. ITC, input tax credit, you can avail only and only against the IGST and GST compensation cess. Why it is so? Because the ITC is a concept under GST, and the GST related duties under customs are only these two duties. Number one, IGST, and number two, the GST compensation cess. So ITC can be availed only against these two and no one else. Right? Okay. Now, the next part. Next part is this. I was telling you that in case you want to work out the amount of GST compensation cess, how to work out that amount? Okay. What would be the amount of GST compensation? So we were having this illustration. We have this illustration with us now. Okay. Now let us extend this illustration further to accommodate the GST compensation cess also. Let us suppose that the question is saying that also work out the amount of GST compensation cess, because the goods which are imported, they are luxury goods or they are demerit goods. Okay. Only in these two cases you need to apply the GST compensation cess. For no other kind of goods, you need to apply this GST compensation cess. It would be applied only when the import of these two kind of goods, either luxury goods or the demerit goods. Right? Now please see, in your computation, where, at what point, at what level this GST compensation cess would come. You have already worked out up to the IGST, right? Now let us see that I have taken this total here, 111 here. Okay, this subtotal has been written again here, subtotal 111. This is point number 4. Okay, now on this subtotal, you first applied IGST, which is there also. You applied IGST at 10%. It was on point number 4 value. So 10% on 111, it was 11.1. The same is written here. Right? And now you need to work out GST compensation cess. So the level, the step at which you need to compute GST compensation cess, it would be once you computed your IGST, then you need to compute this GST compensation cess, and you need to compute it only when the goods imported are either luxury or demerit goods. Okay. Now please see, GST compensation says, let us suppose the rate given is say 10%. Now on which value you need to apply this rate? Please note that this rate again is to be applied on number 4. What is number 4? It is this value again. Okay. In other words, the value on which you calculated your IGST, on the same value you need to apply the rate of GST compensation cess also. So 10% of GST compensation cess, this would be 10% on the same value of 111. So this comes to 11.1. This is also the same amount. Obviously, the rate given is the same. IGST rate is 10%. GST compensation cess rate is 10%. Both of the rates are to be applied on the same value. So the same amount. Okay. So if it is same amount, now the value of your imported goods become 133.2. This is the value of imported goods including the custom duties. And which duties we have covered here? We have covered four duties. Number one, the basic custom duty. Point to remember under basic BCD is whether to apply the standard rate or the preferential rate. Okay. Then the SWS, you must remember the rate, which is 10% now. Then number three, IGST, the rate would be given to you in your question. And at number four, it would be GST compensation cess to be applied only when the goods imported are either luxury or demerit goods. Okay. By way of this illustration, I think the computation of these duties is also clear to you. There are number of other duties which we would study in the next session, but even though we are studying two duties, one by the name of anti-dumping duty, the other one by the name of safeguarding duty in the next session, but I want to tell something related to them right away, because there is a connection of, you know, those things here also. Yes, I know that you still do not know about anti-dumping duty and the safeguard duty. No problem. That will be discussed in the next session. But I want to tell you something related to them right away, because it has got a link here also. And please note this point with you. The point is this. Even though so far, and even in our illustration, while working out the value of IGST and GST compensation cess, we have taken the value, which is the value of the goods plus basic custom duty plus SWS. Okay, that is the overall value you have taken for working out your IGST and GST compensation cess. Okay, but please remember that in case the question also gives anti-dumping duty or safeguard duty, then in that case you must remember that IGST and GST compensation cess, both of these are to be computed on a value which should include the value of anti-dumping duty as well as the value of safeguard duty. Got it? Even though I know that you still do not know about anti-dumping and the safeguard duty. No problem. But just remember this point, that if the question has anti-dumping duty or safeguard duty also, then to work out the amount of IGST or GST compensation cess, you need to include the amount of anti-dumping duty and safeguard duty in the overall value here. And then on that total value, you need to apply the IGST rate or the GST compensation rate to work out these things. IGST amount and the GST compensation cess. Okay. No problem. Just remember this. This is a very vital, very important point here. I am again repeating the point. Even though in our illustration, because so far we have not done anti-dumping and safeguard duty. So in our illustration, it shows that IGST and GST compensation cess is calculated on this value, and this value includes only the value of goods plus BCD plus SWS, right? But if in our question anti-dumping or safeguard duty is also given, make it a point to include that amount of duty also in this value. Include that amount of duty in this value and then work out the amount of IGST and GST compensation cess. I hope that is clear to you. Next session, we are doing the remaining custom duties. Thank you very much.